Hey guys, so I am currently in a new gym in New Zealand. I don't know if you guys can, that's what it looks like. And there's also like an area where you can do like resistance training as well. But I'm in like the warm-up area and I don't really want to just, I'm trying to fix my camera, sorry. I don't really want to disturb anyone at the minute whilst I'm not actually like training. But today we're going to hit a good leg day and I am going to show you how I do my warm up ready for my leg day, and then we'll get going. All right, so first things first, I'm going to put my music on so I don't so we're going to do quite a lot of so I always do like just stretching really, just because it helps loosen up. I try and do it so to loosen up around like my hip flexors and around my glutes and stuff. And also when I did my 5K yesterday, my body is feeling so tight today, you wouldn't even believe it. So I'm just trying to make myself a lot more like looser for today's session because I've not been feeling very flexible or very comfortable when training recently, so I'm just trying to make sure that I'm feeling more myself again. And also because I'm on holiday, I've also not been eating the best and I've also drunk a lot of wine. And usually for me, I'm not entirely sure what it is in alcohol, but for me when I drink alcohol, it like my face puts a bit of weight on. And you can, my face is always the first thing to put weight on for me. So I join the gym and I'm just making sure that I get back to it. Yeah, so what I normally do is I hold all of these stretches for a rough round, I'm gonna say like 30 seconds for each of them, just to get myself all loosened up in my hips and things like that. Also, I've got prickly heat recently and my hands are in so much pain. I'm just too pale and fair skinned for my own liking. So I hold each one for about 30 seconds and then we're going to do some leg press today. I've not leg pressed in the longest time, so that should be fun. And then we're going to get into a nice deep pigeon stretch like this. For me, whenever I pigeon stretch, I always make sure to make sure that I can feel like a real good stretch. I always make sure that my ankle's in line with my knee. And then my back knee's always sort of facing the floor as well. Some people might not be able to get to this position, so you can have your foot slightly closer to your groin when you stretch. And just chest up nice and tall if you can. You feel a nice stretch along the front of your hips and your quad. And then swap sides after 30 seconds. This one just doesn't seem to be as flexible as the other one, but we live and learn. Oh, I feel really tired today. Right, so I'm just gonna stretch out my calves and my back of my legs. Oh, I always stretch into a deep lunge because I feel like for me, lunging really helps when I try and stretch out my back as well, because I do just turns and it really helps with my thoracic mobility, which I'm lacking a lot of at the minute. Also, this gym is so bloody hot. They've not got the fans on. And the weather outside is boiling, so. And I didn't think about putting a t-shirt on underneath, which is just daft. Oh, right, we're gonna do down dog. And then just cycle through your feet, push one heel down to the floor and then into the other.
Right, so my microphone didn't turn on for some reason, but what I was saying here is that I'm actually 4 kilograms heavier than what I normally would be, and that's obviously because I've not been doing any exercise recently, so this is my first kind of leg day back that's sort of full on. So I'm starting off with an RDL, and what I was saying is make sure your feet are directly underneath your hips and make sure your shoulders are nice and pinched whenever you pick up a bar. Always bend your legs. Never pick up a bar with straight legs. And then from this position, you're just going to have your feet underneath your hips, but hip width apart. And then you're going to keep your shoulders back nice and pinched. And then from this position, you're going to push your hips back towards the wall and let the barbell drop until you feel it pulling your hamstrings. And then you're going to pull up to your starting position again. But at the same time, don't thrust your hips forward because it doesn't do anything for you. But yeah, so this is my first set. I've done a nice, easy warm-up. So on the bar is, I'm going to say, 40 kilograms because the bar's 20 and then I've got 20, so 10 each side. So I'm going to do 4 lots of 8 just to get myself going. And then each time I'm going to add weight to it. And that's me finished for that set. And I do believe after this one, I was talking about how my hamstrings were on fire because I've forgotten what that felt like. And then we're moving on to the second round. So we're doing 4 sets. I made sure the first 2 were relatively light. So again, 40 kilograms because I'm doing a heavy leg session on everything else. And then we're going to get back into it. Zany boss was our door, brand new bag. So now we're onto the third set, which is 50 kilograms. And as you can tell, I'm preparing myself for this because my hamstrings already feel like they're dying. So yeah, making sure the bra's in place because you don't want them falling out. And then always bend your legs, like I said, when you pick the bar up and pinch your shoulder blades together. Get your hands nice and comfortable in front of you. And take your time. Make sure you can feel your hamstrings pinching as you fold downwards. Make sure your chin fairly close to your chest so your spine remains neutral. Addy boys got some 60s in my bag. Lips sealed, ain't pillow talking, I'm no rag. In my earlobe, got 2 carats, VVS. Got a penthouse near Rodeo, out for stress. All this money, when I grew up, I had nothing. Filled with backstabbing, my old life is disgusting. Can't believe it, gotta thank God that I'm living comfortably. Getting checks, I don't believe, but she say she done with me. Burn some bridges and I let the fire light the way. Kicking my feet up, left the PJs on a PJ. And I think you can tell by this point, I was struggling. My grip strength was non-existent. And that is basically what I was explaining in this part. And I was also explaining that now we're going on to doing leg press. But I was also explaining in this part of the video that in the gym that I work at home, the leg press itself is, I think it's 53.2 kilograms. So I'm going to put 20s on each side just to get myself nice and steady and get it started easier. And then I'm not sure what the weight is altogether, but all I know is what's the plates on. So the plates at the minute is 40 kilograms. And then I don't know what the weight of the machine is, so it could be more than that. But I'm going off what plates I've used. So I'm doing 4 sets of 8 just to get myself burning. Yeah, I'm a big dog and I walk around with no leash. I got water on me, yeah, everything on Fiji. Zany boss, what's our door, brand new bag. College girls, give a nigga head in my raps. Rockstar life, so much money, I'll make you laugh. Hey, the bitch they hate and you can't miss what you never had. Hey, hey, off the juice, coding got me tripping. Cut the coupe, walk a roof is missing. Ice, lemonade, my neck was tripping. At this point, my body is feeling pretty awful, like I've just tried to explain in this video here. Also, I was explaining that I was sweating a lot and the fans in the gym were not on, so I was dying more than I probably would if I had some actual air. And then also, when you do a leg press, always make sure that your lower back is flat on the bench and do not round it up when you bring your knees to your chest. And then from here on this set, I've just added an extra 10 on each side. Okay, so that is 60 kilograms at the minute. Ice, lemonade, my neck was tripping. A rock star, pack up cars, tipping walls, hey. Add up raw, finish nuts, and X bars, hey.
I was 15, I took codeine with my dog, ayy. Did it break us, it put methazine, I feel nauseous. Put up a stick and I hop on a plane.
And at this point, I know for a fact I was already moaning that I still had two sets left, but at the same time I was also moaning about the fans again and how sweaty I am. And then I was also explaining that I was going to add on two extra 10s, so a 10 each side. So that's actually 40 kilograms each side. So I'm doing one round of 80 and I'm talking to myself right now about how much pain I'm in. But you got to work for it, haven't you? And I was actually trying to work out how much the machine was, but the sticker just wasn't on there. So you just have to work with what you've got, guys, and go off what you know, which is 80 kilograms altogether. So here we go.
Still in my wall, shit is so risky, I gotta be gifted, he blessed me with fortune and fame. I remember from 50, I couldn't go back empty, I knew I was stuck to the game. Loyal and I never change, I'm never gonna go against the grain. Never gonna be the one turn on my brother when police just gotta detain. I won't ever love a bitch more than my mother, and that's on my government name.
Right, so it's now 100 plus whatever the machine is, so I'm gonna do 6 and then I'm finished on the press because I'm sweating so bad.
No one, I wish everybody could pay. Cause we counting up every day. Getting hot tiling in the grave. Zany boss, what's our door? Brand new bag. College girls, give a nigga head in my raps. Rockstar life, so much money, I'll make you laugh. Hey, the bitches they hate, and you can't miss what you never had. Hey, hey, I'm the juice. Coding got me tripping. Cut the coupe, Walker roof is missing. Ice, lemonade, my neck was tripping.
Now we are using the seated hamstring curl. I wanted to use a lying one, but the gym, what I'm trying to explain to you right now is the gym that I'm in didn't have one. And also I was saying that make sure you place the knee pad just above your knees and make sure that the pad rests comfortably underneath your Achilles or just on the back of your heel. And make sure that your knees are in the crevice at the end of the C and get ready to pull them towards your bottom, your feet, of course. But make sure you take your time, okay? So we're going to do 3 sets of 10 on this one. And I'm just waffling on about how much I am dying right now and I'm trying to concentrate. Wasn't the best, and then I supersetted my leg extensions with reverse lunges. Also, I would have videoed more on each of these sets, but my camera decided to have a funny turn and the battery went down to 7%. So I only managed to film one set of these, but this super set was three sets of 10 leg extensions and then six reverse lunge on each leg. And then after this, we then decided to go into a sissy squat. And this was after I had a little bit of a rest and after I'd done my reverse lunges. Now we're going into a sissy squat. I was just explaining that this was my second to last exercise and that I was holding a 15 kilogram dumbbell. So as you push yourself up again, do not thrust your hips forward. I don't know why these people on Instagram think that that's going to help you in any way because it's not. It's actually going to disengage your glutes. It's not going to do you any benefit whatsoever. But make sure that when you're holding the dumbbell that it's on your sternum and that your shoulder blades are nice and pinched together. Sissy squats are a bit of a pain. They are quite an isolated exercise for the quad, but just remember to take your time and if they hurt, don't do overly loads because it can be a little bit strenuous on your knees. So for this one, I did three sets of 10, and I'm just saying that that was my first set, and I've got two left. So yeah. First proper leg day I filmed in forever. Today I made a promise to myself that I'm going to start eating better again, and I'm also going to exercise more regular because I don't. You know, when you look in the mirror and you kind of don't recognise yourself. That's kind of how I'm feeling at the minute. But this session went really well, and I feel really happy. But I'm not going to let it get me down. I'm just going to take every day as it comes and just be consistent and dedicated to what I actually want to achieve. Because I just recently haven't had the motivation to do any of that. So I think this session will prove that I'm getting back on track. And I'm excited to see what else I can do. I also did calf raising at the end, but I just thought calf raising is so boring and pointless to film, so I didn't film it. But yeah, this is one of many sessions I've had in New Zealand, and many more to come, but thanks for watching. Yeah, sorry, it broke. Came out then, but like I'm all sweaty and I'm a mess, but I'm gonna go home and have dinner now. And yeah, so I'll catch you guys soon, and I'll be putting more workout videos on more consistently. I've been slacking a lot, obviously, for various reasons, but we're back in now, and I'll see you guys soon.